Sixth standard children, I am going to give you the answers for the national symbol lesson, that is civics first lesson, term 2. Understand? Already we finished. Choose the correct answer, fill in the blanks. Many Roman letters we finished, from Roman letter 1 till Roman letter 7. In the previous classes we finished those Roman letters, and now I am going to give you Roman letter 8 and 9. That is, choose the correct sentence. Roman letter 8. Only one is there. Which sentence is correct? You have to write. August 15 is celebrated as the Independence Day. November 26 is celebrated as the Republic Day. October 12 is celebrated as Gandhi Jayanti. Which one is correct? Yes, very good. A, the first one. August 15 is celebrated as the Independence Day. The correct answer is A. Then, next one, Roman letter 9. That is, answer the following. First one, you copy it down from your book, children. Understand? It is in page number 164. You just turn over page number 164. The question is, what do the colors in our national flag represent? It is in page number 164. Turn your page, all of you. 164, take. Here, other symbols of our country. Down you have national flag. Can you see this, children? In that fourth line, the saffron at the top represent valor and sacrifice. The green at the bottom represents fertility and prosperity. The white band in between represent honesty, peace and purity. The Ashoka Chakra or the wheel in navy blue represents truth and peace. Till truth and peace you have to mark. From the saffron till truth and peace. Okay, next, second one. Second short answer. Second answer the following. I'll read out the question. What are the parts of a national emblem? It is in page number 165. Take page number 165, national emblem. Okay, national emblem, last. Can you see, all of you? National emblem, page number 164. The four lions on the top of the Ashoka pillar of Sarnath was chosen to be a national emblem. Point one. Point two. The national emblem was accepted on 26 January 1950. Satyameva Jayate has been inscribed at its bottom. Next point. It means truth alone triumphs. The national emblem consists of two parts, the upper and the lower parts. The upper part has four lions facing the north, south, east and west. This is on a circular pedestal. One can only see three lines at a time. The lower part has an elephant, a horse, a bull, and a lion. The wheel of righteousness is placed between them. This emblem is found at the top of the government, communication, Indian currency, and passport. or else you can write till this. The lower part has an elephant, horse, a bull and a lion. The wheel of righteousness is placed between them. Till them it's enough. Understand, children? So from the national emblem, till, placed between them, till that it's okay. Then next one, third. Third, answer the following. What is the question? Third question. What are the salient features of the national anthem? It is in page number 165 and 166. Take page number 165. National anthem. Down, you have that paragraph. The last paragraph, national anthem. Janagana Mana is our national anthem. It symbolizes the sovereignty and integrity of our nation. This anthem was written by Rabindranath Tagore in Bengali. This was transcribed in Hindi and was accepted by the Constituent Assembly on 24 January 1950. And it continues in next page. The rules to be observed while singing the anthem. This also you have to write. Okay, children, the three points till the third point. This anthem has to be sung at the duration of 52 seconds. Everyone should stand erect while singing the national anthem. One should stand, understand the meaning while singing. Till that, the third answer. Understand? And fourth one. Fourth, answer the following. I'll read out the question. Draw and define the Indian rupee symbol. It is in page number 166. Page number 166. Take all of you. Here, this paragraph, the middle paragraph. Currency of India. Irka, the paragraph, the fifth line. You can see the fifth line. The symbol of rupee is this, the symbol you know. This was designed by Devoday Kumar from Tamil Nadu in the year 2010. Only this much. Okay. Then, fifth answer. Fifth question. Where do we use our national emblem? It is in page number 166. 165. Where do we use our national emblem? It is in 165. National emblem mark panningala. Second. Adhuk pakkathile irukku parunga. This emblem. Strike out this. There you write. The national emblem. The national. Anga neenga ezhudhanum. This-ku badhila. Strike out this. Adha adichittu the national ezhudhikonga. Emblem there itself you have. The national emblem is found at the top of the government communication, Indian currency and passport. This is the fifth answer. Fifth answer the following. Okay, then sixth one. Sixth answer. I'll read out the question. Sixth answer. It is in page number, that is question is, who wrote the national pledge? Who wrote the national pledge? I'll write the answer. Strike out who. Who adichirano? Adhuk badala you write this name. Answer. Paidimari Vengata Subbaya Rao. Vengata Subbarao. Answer. Subbarao wrote the National Pledge. Okay, children. Then seventh one. What are the animals found in the bottom of the emblem? It is in page number 165. Page number 165. Just take page number 165. The national emblem you marked, no? That paragraph. The picture keeler kaparna. The lower part. Adhukku padala? The bottom. Strike out the lower part. Lower part adicharna. Understand? Lower, strike out the lower part. Instead of that, you write bottom. B-O-T-T-O-M. Bottom. The bottom has an elephant, bracket la energy, bracket la irukkadala ezhudanum, you have to write. Okay, the bottom has an elephant energy, comma, a horse speed, comma, a bull hard work, and a lion majestic, bracket la majestic, like that. Till that is enough. Okay, this is seventh one. And eighth, answer the following. What are the natural national symbols? It is in page number 163. Page number 163. Take page number 163. Natural national symbols. Here they gave you the pictures. That's and the name matter ninga ezhudhina podum. No need to write the year. Only the name. Banyan tree, the site peacock, river Ganges, river dolphin, king cobra, lotus, tiger, elephant, lactobacillus, mango. Understand? The natural national symbols are put it. You have to write only the names. No need to write full. Year la venda. Can you understand then? You just note down the names only. And the names matto bracket panikonga. That is eighth short answer. And ninth one. Ninth answer. Question, I'll read out the question. Ninth one. Where is the peacock sanctuary located in Tamil Nadu? I'll write the answer on the board. The peacock sanctuary is located at Veeramalai in Tamil Nadu. Veeramalai, Veeramalai in Veeramalai in Tamil Nadu. That's all. So children, I gave you all the answers for the evaluation, the exercises. All the answers I gave you, children. That is from Roman letter 1, choose the correct answer. and Roman letter 2, fill in the blanks. And Roman letter 3, choose the correct answer. Roman letter 4, fill in the blanks. Then Roman letter 5, choose the correct option. Roman letter 6, match and choose the wrong pair. Then Roman letter 7, choose the wrong sentences. And Roman letter 8, choose the correct sentence. Roman letter 9, answer the following. So till that I gave you, this lesson is over. Have you understand, children? And among they didn't give you the detail answer and short answer separate panni kudukla. They gave you the 9 answers. Among them, first one is detail answer. D pottukonga, first one. Detail answer. And second one is also, can you see? Can you see this? Second one is detail answer. And third one is detail answer. These three are the detail answers. Other all short answers only. Fourth one, SA pottukonga. SA means short answer. Sixth one, short answer. Seventh one, short answer. Eighth one, short answer. And ninth one, short answer. Understand? So, if I give you this detail, this question, it will come for the detail answer. Okay, children. So, this lesson is over. The national symbols. First, you just write in your classwork. Then only it will be easy for you to learn. Okay. All the best, children. Thank you. We'll see you in the next class. Bye.